So that is the last class we are attending here, and today our objective is that finding out the probability of x in that either side of mu x, what I have told in the last lecture. As you can know that p of small x if less or equals to mu x, so we can write that p of x greater than mu x equals to half. Okay, so p, that is p of x less than equals to mu x, it means that if you are finding out that CDF obviously of that x less or equals to mu x, that is half. If you are taking greater than, so it is also half. Area under the curve is 1, so if you are integrating the curve in that region of plus infinity to minus infinity, so the result is always equals to 1. Okay, so the probability of finding out x in that range of x1 and x2 can be obtained by integrating f of x as p of x1 x x2, that is ranging of x2 to x1, f of x dx. So what is the value? That integration of that fx, which is a Gaussian distribution, that is a bell-shaped function, that is 1 by root over 2 pi sigma x into e to the power minus x minus mu x square divided by 2 sigma x square dx. Now if you are integrating them out, so what will be the result? That is the cumulative distribution function or the CDF on the normalized Gaussian random variables. We know that f of x equals to here plus infinity to minus infinity is the range. Now if you are finding out the cumulative distribution function, so the upper limit, which is plus infinity over that general interpretation of that integration of CDF, we are just changing it to that x, so where x is a finite one. So where f of x, that is equals to 1 by root over 2 pi sigma x into e to the power x mu x square by 2 sigma square x. Now you can easily integrate it out. If you are putting that x minus mu x divided by 2 sigma x of root 2 is y, so we can easily write that what is dx, that is if you are taking a derivative in the both sides, so obviously dx equals to root over 2 into sigma x minus of dy. So if x tends to infinity, y also tending to infinity. If x is tending to x, y is tending to mu x minus x by root over 2 sigma x. So I am just putting this value right here. So instead of x in the main integration, I am just changing it to that y value, and that y value is replaced with this. So finally that f of x is coming as integration of minus infinity to mu x minus x, that divided by root over 2 sigma x. Okay, so 1 by root over 2 pi sigma x into e to the power y square. Here dx and dy conversion is given, that instead of dx we should write dy, so I have to write minus sigma x of root over 2 dy. Now integrating it out, it will be giving as minus 1 by root over pi with that range of this e to the power minus y square dy, where the range is it is infinity to mu x minus x by root over 2 sigma x. So finally we can take a half and finally write this inside up. We are just shuffling the limit from that upper limit to lower limit, so it will be coming as 2 as a multiplier, as you know. So we are taking that the function is eventually distributed, so we are taking the half of one side. So obviously it is half of 2 by root pi integration of this limit equals to half of ERFC, that is ERFC of mu x minus x divided by sigma x of root 2. So this particular ERFC is called that complementary error function. So this particular one is called that complementary error function. That complementary error function is basically written as ERFC mu x minus x divided by sigma x of root 2, that is multiplied with half. So that function, when integrated, it will giving at that new function is called that ERFC function. This is the inbuilt function in a MATLAB operator. You can easily find it out the definition of the function, and it can be easily resolved into mathematical program also. You can easily use it in different programs. So ERFC is already predetermined function and already written in MATLAB for its predeterministic value. So now, what is f of x equals to half ERFC mu x minus x that divided by sigma x of root 2. So as long as x increases, the complementary error function decreases. So that complementary error function will decrease as long as the x is increases. So it is not monotonously increasing. So this is not that CDR. Now, special case of that Gaussian random variables here, that you can consider this particular case. In that case of Gaussian random variables, for mu x equals to 0, if you are considering, and sigma x square equals to 1. So what is the meaning of this? That you are having one Gaussian pulse which is distributed in this way, and that is 0 point, and here it is the mu x. Okay. So one Gaussian distribution is distributed along that 0 point, one Gaussian distribution is distributed in that mu x equals to 1. So if you are writing this, so another Gaussian pulse is just like this. So we are taking two symbols here, either mu x equals to 0 with that given sigma x, and another one is mu x equals to 1 at that given sigma x. So these two are the general cases where you have considered the general Gaussian PDF. Now if you are writing in this way, for that mu x equals to 0, you will be getting that f of x equals to 1 by root over 2 pi sigma x e to the power mu x minus x whole square by 2 sigma square. So equals to f of x equals to 1 by root over 2 pi e to the power x square by 2. Okay. That is called the normalized PDF or the Gaussian PDF. So here I have given the clear cut diagram, that is f of x, which the first one is representing, this first one is representing 1 and the second case representing 0. So for the second case we have considering this one. So here that central moment or that sigma is given as 1, and that mu x, that is the expectation, is 0. So with that 0 mean and 1 sigma, 0 mean 1 variance, and another is 1 mean 1 variance. So 1 mean and 1 variance and 0 mean 1 variance, if you are considering these two signal, they will be giving like this. So f of x equals to 1 by root over 2 pi integration of minus infinity to plus infinity in this way, but when the x is given to us, so you have to calculate it for that minus infinity to x here. So you can see this diagram here. Now this function cannot be evaluated, so it will never give us the finite result. Okay. So it is better to introduce a new function to get that finite result. So what is the new function? The name of the new function is q function. Okay. And that particular q function is an analyzing function to analyze the effect of the noise in the digital communication system. So the q function is basically is representing this particular one. The q function is a shaded area in the positive tail direction as y less or equals to x. So this is the region of that q function here. And what is the definition of the q? It is given that q of y equals to integration of y to infinity f of x dx, integration of y to infinity 1 by 2 pi e to the power minus x square dx. Now we can write that infinity to plus to minus f of x dx equals to 1. So therefore q of minus y equals to 1 minus qy. So finally we can conclude as here f of x equals to 1 minus qx. So one CDF can easily evaluated by that particular q function. So if you want to distribute that particular function in the term of CDF, it cannot be directly evaluated out by that integration, because infinity to x is quite tricky to integrate. So we better constitute a new function, that is qy, and that qy is dominated by that region of that positive tail direction, what I have told in this particular region. And therefore, if you are writing that CDF function, so it is basically this for that continuous random variables. So here, what is q of minus y? You are just placing this minus y, so that the reverse will come. So it will be 1 minus of qy. Okay, so if you are integrating this q of minus y and q of plus y, so obviously it is minus infinity to y and y to plus infinity, so obviously it is giving 1 as in the CDF. So finally, what is the value of the CDF can be evaluated out, that is f of x equals to 1 minus qx. So if qx known to you, we are having the different sort of values to find out qx. So if qx is known to you, so subtracting 1 minus this qx value will be giving that different value of fx. Say it is f of x plus 1, x2, x3, x4. In this way, you are getting that fx. If you are joining them up in this way, so you will be getting what is the final value of f of x given in this particular equation. So that is all for my today's class. And here in this class, I have detailed given what is the basic cases of CDF and PDF. Before that, what is the Gaussian distribution function, what is the special case, how you have to evaluate the 1 and 0 cases, and in the further communication program, what is ERFC, I have already told, and what is that QY, that Q function, that is very, very much evaluating, that is very, very much important to evaluate such function which is not directly integrable, and finally, the CDF can be calculated out by this particular one. So, thank you very much for this today's lecture class. And we have covered all total 7 lecture in this particular domain. In the final time, we'll much more considering different more cases on this particular PDF, CDF, and this distribution function. So here, always keep in mind that the integration what we have already discussed, it is not integrable right now all this point directly. So you have to consider them individually to find out the main result. So therefore, in the statistical cases, the CDF sometimes is not directly integrable, because the values are not deterministic in nature. So you have to calculate it step by step, and the reverse plotting of the function is giving it that CDF in this particular one. So thank you very much for listening to this particular lecture, and we have covered some general ideas and topic how to interact with the probability and statistics in the form of mathematical calculation, and it is very, very much important for that communication engineering. So thank you for all for attending this class, and in the next classes we will discuss about that other side. It means what is the likelihood ratio, what is the Cauchy distributions, and other distributions are there. We will discuss a lot on this. So thank you very much for this class. See you early next in my next class.